Hi, I'm Mary. Thank you for joining us today while we stretch and get a little stronger so our everyday activities are just a little easier to do. Before you begin this or any other exercise program, you'll want to check with your doctor, and he'll tell you exercises you should and shouldn't do. You'll also want to wear loose, comfortable clothing like Sue and I have on so that you, when you bend, you're not restricted at all, and when you stretch, you're free to stretch. You'll want to make sure that when you have your loose, comfortable clothing on, you also want to check your environment and make sure your environment isn't going to impede you. We're going to be reaching to the sides, so we'll look to the sides. We're going to be reaching up, so you want to look up, and you want to look all around your chair. Speaking of chairs, you want to make sure you're in a good, sturdy chair. And you'll notice Sue and I are sitting to the front of our chairs. If that bothers your back, then you can put some pillows behind you. But the reason we're sitting in the front of our chairs is to make sure our bellies and our backs work hard all while we're doing our exercises. Plus, it frees our hips up so they're more able to move laterally and bring them right back into the middle. So, you have loose, comfortable clothes on, you're in a good, sturdy chair, you've checked your environment, you've checked with your doctor. Now you want to have water handy. So we'll be drinking our water before, during, and after our time together. But you can drink water, of course, anytime you want. Speaking of you, you'll want to make sure that you work at your own pace. If Sue and I are working too quickly for you, you slow down. You can even stop and join us later. If you think Sue and I are going too slowly for you, and you can pick up the pace and do it safely, then you go right ahead and do that. You want to make sure you do your best, so you don't want to push or force or bounce or do any move. You want to move nice and slowly and smoothly. And of course, you know, if you eat well, that's fuel for your body, and that means you have all that energy that you can work out and stay with us to become nice and strong. And of course, you'll want to pay attention to your body always, always, always. If you get lightheaded or if there's any pain, that's your body's way of telling you to stop. Now, before we begin this program, let's meet Sue.
Hi, I'm Sue. I have two titanium hips. I broke my wrist in two places 4 years ago, and I have a plan. My plan is to live forever.
Good.
So far, so good.
Perfect. I love that. I love that. That's perfect. Now, do you have any hobbies or things you love to do?
I like to walk. I like to read. And I love to collect coupons and save money at the market.
Perfect. Perfect. That sounds great. And if you're a coupon collector, I'll bet that you've got a lot of options.
I have a lot of coupons.
Yeah, but I'm saying you can get like coupons over the internet, you can get them in the newspaper, you can get them in the mail.
I have a friend who I see every 2 weeks, mm-hmm. and she brings me a stack about this thick.
Oh, so you're busy.
And in fact, I have the ones I've gone through, and I bring them to the Simsbury Senior Center, and they cut them up and distribute them.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, so I have it here. I'm going to take it up afterwards.
Perfect. Well, that sounds like a good idea, and it sounds like Sue's making the world a better place. Now, today, we're going to be working with something with a lid on it. So, it can be small, it can be big, because we're practicing the ability for our fingers to peel something off and then to push on. If you say to yourself, you know, I would love to be able to get my lid off a little easier, but my hands, they just are so sore. It's hard for me to do. So, if you get something like a big old leather glove, number one, you have the padding, and the leather is non-skid. So you can actually kind of peel it off a little easier.
Oh, that's a good idea.
With a leather glove, yeah. And if you say to yourself, really, I don't have any leather gloves, that's okay. You probably have a dish towel or a face cloth. And if you make it damp, it's a lot easier to bring it over the edge and you can peel it off with that.
How about the latex gloves used for washing dishes? Would that help?
Sure, sure. Yeah, it would give you a nice grip. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, that's what I use when I take lids off where I have to unscrew. After I knock it with a knife, which you're never supposed to do, I do it.
They sell those poppers that pop up. And another good thing is you take an elastic band and put it around it, and that gives you a lot of good traction.
That's a good idea. Mm-hmm. I will try that one because I have a lot of elastic bands. Okay, so run around and find something with a lid on it. Some kind of a lid where you really have to peel off and push down. And again, it can be something small. You can have a small container. You can have a yogurt container. You can have anything at home where you just peel the lid off. Got it? Okay. So are you ready to begin?
I am ready.
Okay. So we're just going to begin by holding our containers because they're very light. We're going to place both hands underneath them. We're going to sit nice and tall with our bellies in and our chest high. Our shoulders are back and down. And all we're going to do is bring it side to side. So we're bringing it a little to one side and a little to the other. And what we're doing is starting for a rotation. So this is good for our spine and it's good for your intestine. And of course, if you start this in the day, you'll know that there's no better way than to start the day than with freshly squeezed organs. Because I know you probably have a joke for me, right?
Let's see. If I thawed out dry ice, could I go swimming without getting wet?
Oh, I like that. That's a good one. Let's bring it center. I'm using that one. Okay. Now with your hands underneath, you're just going to lift it up a little, and as you do, you're going to lean back a little and then come forward. So this is just working on the hips. There you go. So your shoulders are relaxed and down. Your elbows are dropped down, and they're very close to your ribs. And so your hands are just reaching out, so there's no gripping of the thumb. Sometimes your thumb would hurt if you really gripped. This is a very nice, loose move. There you go. Good job. Now, we're going to flip it over. So we're going to take one hand and put it on the bottom. And then we're going to just flip it over to the other hand and flip it over. There you go. Now, if you have anything in this and the lid isn't on tight, you're going to be in big, big trouble. There you go. So all we're doing is shifting it side to side, but it's working on the rotation of the wrist. There you go. That's perfect. Now, we're going to get it very exciting, and we're going to draw it out a little more. So when we flip it over here, we're going to bring it back a little. Then we're going to flip it here, and our palm is rotated up, so we're drawing the thumb out. We flip it over, draw it back. There you go. And as you draw it back, you're going to notice your shoulder blade starts to roll in towards your spine, which is a really good thing for strengthening that upper back, which is really good for posture. Like, everything good happens. Now you're going to come right back to center and hold it like this. And we're simply going to bring it side to side. This time our hands are closer together. Last time our hands were underneath. So we're going to be pushing with the palm a little bit. And of course, if we're not pushing tight enough, we're going to lose our little container with a lid on it. Now we're going into a figure eight. So it's down and out and up and over. You're doing great, and only do what's good for you. Pay attention to how your shoulders feel. Your belly's in, your chest is high, and your posture is nice and tall. Then we're gonna hold it right here. We're gonna walk our feet out and drop the hands down. Breathe in, and as you breathe out, you're gonna lean forward a little bit, just a little. Then when we come back, we're gonna lift it up. That's it. We're gonna lean forward just a little. Feel that back? Mm-hmm. And now we're gonna use our back muscles to come right up. There you go. Good job. So you only come forward a little. Feel those back muscles pull you right up. That's great.
You feel in your stomach too.
In the stomach, yes. So our back pulls us up from here. And then when we lean back, our stomach pulls us up from there. So we're really working our back and our stomach. You're right, Sue. Okay, now when we come up, we're going to bring it to one shoulder. So we bend our elbows, bring it to the shoulder, and chop it down.
Like a discus thrower.
Like a discus thrower. You are absolutely right. Except their discuses are a lot heavier than our little containers. There you go. So we're kind of throwing it over our shoulder. And as we do this, we feel a nice stretch on the upper back. And also, again, it's a rotation. So we're turning from one side to the other. Our spines love this. One more on this side, please. And then one more on this side. And come back to center. Good. Now we're going to walk our ankles and knees and feet together.
You want to drink a little water?
Oh, that's a good idea. We're thirsty. If you're not thirsty, you might want to drink a little water anyway. Ah, the nectar of the gods.
It's nice and cold.
Oh, is that good? Okay. So now we're simply going to put our hands on the top, and we're going to try to lift our fingers right off of it. And that's a really, really good exercise because so many times we get up in the morning and our hands are around our coffee cup and they're going through the newspaper or they're on the keyboard. If you drive, they're on your steering wheel. So getting the fingers back to a nice resting length and then pulling your fingers up beyond that. Can you feel that a little bit?
Oh, yeah.
And you feel the tension right on the top of the hand. Mm-hmm. Now, seeing I'm feeling tension and I'm thinking, I don't want to hold this anymore, I'm thinking if you told me a good joke, I'd be a lot happier.
What gets wetter the more it dries?
What gets wetter the more it dries?
A towel.
A towel gets wetter the more it dries? Oh, the more it dries the body, the wetter it got it. Takes me a while. Okay, and now all we're going to do is we're going to actually play on the top of our little container. So even if you have something as small as a yogurt container, you can put the heel of the hand on the edge, and all you're going to do is tap the pointer nice and easy, and then tap the middle finger, and so the heel of your hand can be down or you can have it lifted like Sue, and then the ring finger, and then the middle finger, and then the thumb, and now you're gonna go thumb, pointer, middle, ring.
Da-da-da. Spider.
Like a spider, that's right. Eensy weensy spider crawled up the water spout. Now that you've mastered that, try going in the opposite direction. Pinky, ring, middle, pointer, thumb. Pinky, ring, middle, pointer, thumb. Pinky, ring, middle, pointer, thumb, and shake it out. Could you feel that a little bit?
Yes, you can feel it like underneath.
Underneath, yep, because your hand is stretching out, and also on the top because you're contracting those muscles. Mm-hmm. So, heel of the hand on the edge, pressing down. So, like I said, even though if it's a little yogurt container, or it could be, you know, a little margarine or a butter container, it'll be great. So let's push the palm down, lift the fingertips up. You've got it. And then you're going to dough. Thumb down, pointer, and you can even do it with your hand on a table. Thumb, pointer, middle. And now we're gonna tap just the pointer. The pointer taps. And now the middle finger taps. And now the ring finger taps. And now the baby finger taps. And then we go in sequence. Thumb. So it's like, some people actually, they do this when they're nervous. Bada boom, bada boom. Mm-hmm. Now we're gonna go the other way, now that we have mastered that. Pinky, ring, middle, pointer, thumb. Pinky, ring, middle, pointer, thumb. It's harder for me to go backwards. How about you?
Oh, I played the piano when I was young, so my fingers are kinda used to this.
Cool beans. Okay, one more, and then shake it out. Because you can really feel it on your fingers, and sometimes you can feel it all the way up your wrist, so it's really a fun thing to do. Okay, so we have our container. So let's think about it. Before we do specific work peeling the container off, we're gonna hold the container towards our chest, tap out with the heel, and then add the arms. So we'll hold it close to our chest. Our bellies are in, our chests are high, our shoulders are back and down, and we feel wonderful. So we're gonna extend one leg out just to tap it a little bit and bring it in. And tap it and bring it in. Tap it and bring it in. As you tap it, the heel is down and the toe is up. So you're gonna feel a contraction on the front side of the shin bone, that's your anterior tibialis. And you'll also feel a nice stretch on the back of the calf, the back muscle of your calf. Now we're gonna add our arms. Are you ready?
Ready.
So we're gonna push and pull and push and pull. That's it, push. And you'll notice we're not squeezing our containers too tightly. So if you have a tall yogurt container, or any kind of container, depending on its shape, your hands will wrap around it differently. And remember to hold onto it. If it's hard for you to hold onto it, you can dampen a face cloth or a dish towel. There you go. And right back to center. I could feel that.
Yes.
Alrighty. So again, we're gonna give our hands a break. Anytime you do something where your hand stays in one position for a while, you'll wanna give it a break. So we'll put the container down on our lap or a table next to you, flip the fingertips up, take the other hand and bring your fingertips back. Feel that nice stretch. Can you feel that stretch?
Mm-hmm.
Good. And so if this stretch is difficult for you, if you say, golly, you know, I can't do that comfortably, simply take the other hand, put it behind and try to pull the fingers over. So it's a different kind of stretch. It's not a force stretch. It's one that's initiated by the stretching hand. There you go. And now we're going to switch to the other side. Fingertips up. The stretching hand will push the stretched hand into a nice stretch. And again, you just want to feel how good that stretch feels in the palm, all the way to the wrist. You can feel it all the way to the wrist. And again, if that's difficult for you, take the hand behind the hand you want to stretch, and with your own strength, try to pull those fingers back. You got it. You did it. Great job. And relax. Shake those hands out. Now, when you shake the hands out, shake them out like you have a little bit of water on the ends of your fingertips. And if you could just get that water off, you would be some happy camper. Good. Now we're going to hold it again. This time we're going to hold it to the sides. We're going to tap out with one foot and then the other. Again, our posture is nice and tall. Our buttocks are towards the edge of the chair. And we're just going to start small. Tapping out and in and out and in. Good work. Out and in. Now we're going to add the arms. Now this time, the arms are going to follow the foot. Mm-hmm. So if the foot taps out to the right, our arms go to the right. And if our foot taps out to the left, our arms go to the left. Now we're going to do a brain trick. Okay, we're going to hold it center and tap the toes. And then we're going to flip it over and over. So we're tapping our toes. Good job. Now we're going to hold it center, hold our feet still. Start with the foot, tapping out and in, out and in. Now the first time we did it, the hands followed the feet. Now the hands are going in opposition. Here we go. If the foot goes to the left, we go to the right. If the foot goes, boy, you didn't miss a step on that one, Sue.
I'm pretty good at this stuff.
Ah, I guess you are. So we're going in opposition. If the foot taps out to one side, we're pushing to the other. And of course, because you have one hand on either side, you have to push out and then push in. Last two, please. You're done right here. Wow, I could feel that.
Yes.
So we're going to make a little fist with our hands and then straighten our hands right up. Now you remember, when we were tapping, Sue mentioned that it might be like a spider. But if we take our fingers and put them together and flip one hand on top, push the palms together and then apart, bring our fingers wide and bring them together. This is like a spider doing a push-up on a mirror. That's a thought. Now we're going to let the hand go flat, flip it over, bring all the fingers together and spread them wide. And when we spread them wide, we push the heels of our hands together and we get an awfully nice stretch. And now relax. Interlace the fingers, bring your thumbs towards you and push away. Feel that nice stretch?
Yes.
And again, if this is difficult for you, if it hurts your hands, you'll take one hand, push it on top of the other, sitting tall, relaxing the shoulders, feeling that nice stretch. And if you've done that, then you'll just want to switch where your top hand is. Good. Get that nice stretch and relax. So I'm ready for peeling. How about you?
Sounds like a plan.
Okay. Almost every container has a little edge that you can peel. So I've got four edges. Poor Susan only has one edge.
But it's a big one.
It's a big one. You're right. And I know my yogurt containers, they have no edge at all. I just have to do it. So we're going to put the heel of our hand down, bring the fingers over, and then try to pull it up. And I have to actually push down on it because I have a pretty tough one. Okay, now I'm going to put the lid back on. And the lid just doesn't go back on nice and easily. You have to kind of really line it up, and you have to squish it. And some of them, you can feel it when it does its last pop. Okay, now we're going to take the other hand. So the other hand comes across, the heel of the hand goes on the container, then we peel off with our fingers. I actually have to push down with my other hand to peel this one off. Good work. And then we're going to put it right back on.
I have to tell you, I kept the easy one.
Yeah, I know you kept the easy one. I didn't want to say anything because I said to Sue, try them and see which one you like. She kept the easy one. She said, oh, no, you decide.
Okay, I'm no fool, right?
That's right. That's exactly right. Okay, so now we're all clipped on. Now, we're going to go a little faster. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, get your hands locked on. You're going to lift it and push it down. Lift it and push it down. It doesn't have to close completely. Lift, push, lift, push, lift, push. Our elbows in tight. Pull up, put down, pull up, come down, and up, and down, and now you're done. And just shake it out. So we were making sure that the opposite end that we were peeling was staying close to the container itself. Now we'll do the other side. So we're gonna peel it off, push it on, peel it off, almost cover it, peel it off, cover it, peel it off, cover it. You're doing great. Four more. And three more. And two more. And you are done. Wow, you know what I almost experienced? I have a finger that when I peel like this, my fingers stay in and I have to peel them off. So now we have the cover and the container, and we have one little piece in each hand. So you have the top in one hand and the bottom in the other, okay? So again, this is a nice grip. And if gripping's difficult for you, remember your damp towel or your a mitten or a glove. We're gonna bring both hands down. We're gonna breathe in, and as we breathe out, we're gonna whoosh up. Feel that nice breeze?
Nice breeze.
Okay, we're gonna whoosh up and down. Whooshing up and down. Now we're starting to lean back a little. If we lean back a little, our stomachs have to work hard to pick us up. So our elbows are down by our sides. We're leaning back with something that does not weigh a lot, but our hands are holding it differently. Last two. There you go, that's perfect. Last one, and now we're gonna switch. So our top goes on one side and the bottom goes on the other. And you'll notice that one hand is close together and one hand, the fingers are far apart. Okay, so this time the thumbs are up and we're going to bring the sides of the dish towards us as we lean back. And again, lean back just until you feel that stomach go, excuse me. And we say, stomach, you're gonna be so happy we did this. And so lean back and then breathe out as you come up. Lean back, breathing in, breathe out as you come up. Two more, good job. And now you're done.
Some more water?
Some more water. So let's put our container together-ish and have another drink of water.
Mary, do you know what attorneys wear to court?
Attorneys wear to court. They wear a tie and what?
They wear lawsuits.
Lawsuits. I love it. I can count on you for good jokes. Thank you, Sue. Remember her jokes because they're fun to retell. Okay, so now we have one in each side. We were leaning back a little bit. Now we're going to lean back and we're going to hold it there. So when you lean back, make sure you drop the chin and make sure you drop the ribs, but somehow you're keeping the chest up. So we don't want to arch the back out. We're going to crisscross one over the other and then the other over the other. There you go. You'll notice that our elbows are bent. We're leaning back. If leaning back hurts your back, then you sit up nice and tall. So now we're gonna make this a little bigger. So we're slicing one over the other, and then one over the other. Now, we're gonna reach forward, and as we pull the elbows back, we're going to lean forward. Here we go. We're gonna reach forward, and pull the elbows back and lean forward. Reach forward. I always think of myself as serving hors d'oeuvres. Would you like a scallop wrapped in bacon? There you go. One of my favorite hors d'oeuvres is something that's like so bad for you. It's those little hot dogs that are wrapped in that phyllo dough, and you dunk them in mustard, and they taste so good.
Pigs in a blanket.
Pigs in a blanket. That's it. Pigs in a blanket. That's it. And lean and draw to you. Good work, you got it. And lean, and draw to you, and relax. Could you feel that a little bit?
Yes.
Yeah. So we're gonna give our hands a break now. So we're gonna take our container, make it go nice and tight. There we go. And so before we put it down into the bottom counter, we're gonna put it up to the top shelf. So we're going to put it in one hand. The other hand's right on our knee. We're going to stretch up and put it right into the top cupboard. Then we're going to take it down. And let's put it in the other top cupboard. Stretch up to put it in the top cupboard and bring it down. Now we're going to go to the medium cupboard. So we bring it up a little, put it in the medium cupboard, take it out, and switch. We're going to pick the other hand up, medium, put it in the cupboard, bring it down. Now, we're going to do it right on the counter. So we're going to bring it to the side, slide it on the counter, bring it back, and switch. You're doing a good job. Slide it on the counter, bring it back, and switch. Now we're going to the bottom cupboard, not all the way down, but halfway down. We have our container. We bring it and put it in the bottom cupboard, and back, and switch. Bring it down. There you go. Now we're going into the really bottom cupboard. So because we know we're going to lean forward and we know we don't want anything to happen to the back, we take our hand, put it on the knee for support. Breathe in, sitting tall. And as you breathe out, put it way down in the bottom cupboard. There you go. And now lift it up and switch. You're doing a great job. Hand for support on the leg. Shoulders back and down. Lean forward and slightly off to the side. Feel a nice stretch in the back. Put it in the bottom cupboard. Take it out and bring it back. All this stuff about containers is making me hungry.
Well, this is like Jell-O, so I'm in the mood for Jell-O.
Oh, I'm in the mood for, what is this, meat and potatoes and a vegetable?
Like a TV dinner.
Like a TV dinner, that's right. So we're going to take our containers and without regret, put them right down. We're going to interlace the fingers and push straight down, keeping the head high. Shoulders are relaxed and down. And again, if this hurts your hands, simply place one hand on top of the other. And we're going to bring both hands over to one side. And they're low, but we sit tall and we look away from our hands. And then we come back to center. Bring our hands right over our lap and towards the other side, pushing down with both hands. Our shoulders are relaxed and down. We hold our head high and we look over and away from our hands, over the shoulder. Slowly we come back, bring them up to center. Shoulders are relaxed. Bring them over to one side, look away. Back to center, please, and over to the other side. Look away. And back to center. Bring them all the way over your head and over to one side. Pay attention to how this feels on your shoulder. Back to center, please, and over to the other side. Right back to center and float the hands down. Hold the back sides of your chair so your arms are nice and straight. Push the chest forward and up. Feel that nice stretch. And turn and look over one shoulder. Back to center, please, and over the other shoulder. And back to center. Then we relax the hands down. Pull the shoulders up, back, and down.
That feels really good.
Doesn't that feel great? Because that was a lot of upper body work. And we're simply going to stretch one leg out, hand on the knee. Just slide the hand down a little bit until you feel a gentle stretch in the back. And then draw that hand straight up all the way back. Turn and look back. And switch hands. Breathe in. Breathe out. Slide the hand down the leg. Slowly bring it up. Keep your eyes on it. And bring 2 feet together. Shoulder rolls one more time. You did a great job today, and so did you. So let's take a great big breath in. And as you exhale, know that all will be well. Yay! Let's have a little water.
Funding for Simsbury Community Television is provided in part by contributions from viewers like you. Thank you.